Hello.
I made a video about how to print off a guitar template, and it's had a few responses and a lot of people saying questions like, how do I print off to scale the template? So what I'm going to do is try and show you that now. So I'm going to take a template from Electric Herald. So after downloading that, what we're going to do is go to File and Import, find that on the desktop, find the template, and just click OK. So what you'll see here is this rectangle is effectively the size of an A4 piece of paper. That's why this is larger than this. So what we're going to do is highlight this. So highlight the template, and as you'll see, you've got this this border around it. So we're going to go to Extensions, Render, Grids, come down to Grid, and these are the settings I use, and Apply. Now you won't see the grid just yet, I have to zoom in. So you can see the grid, and this helps with printing out this this template. So what you want to do now is highlight the grid and the template underneath, and I have a bit of a problem trying to get the grid to group to the template. So what I do is I bring the grid across slightly like this. So I'll take the body first. What I'd have now is this is the grid highlighted, and I'm going to come to the outside where the template is. I'm going to hold down Shift and left click, and as you see, it's all highlighted like this. You've got these lines as well. So now go up to Objects and go to Group, and now if I click on the picture, it will move around and it keeps the grid with it, so the grid doesn't move to the template. So what I'm going to do now is, I think that will come off better if I turn it round slightly. So now all I do is I lay this picture over the paperwork here, print this page, and just print that, then move it across to this side, print this side, and again the bottom part of it, and that will print off that to scale. Then you have to cut round the border and you can line it up using these grids. If there isn't a center line on here, you can do that using any of these marking tools. So yeah, that's how I do it now. Beforehand I was using a separate PDF file. It's very difficult that way. This way I find is much easier. You don't have to save anything or muck about with anything. The grid helps. So just make sure that when you put the grid on, you bring the grid across the template, so that way you can click on the grid and the template. Otherwise, if the grid was on top of it, I find it kind of difficult to highlight both of them. So that may help. Thanks very much. Bye bye.